We want to evaluate each of the exponential expressions to illustrate one of the properties of logarithms. So to evaluate e raised to the power of natural log 2, we're going to create an equation by setting this equal to x. So if we can determine the value of x, we'll be able to evaluate this expression. And since we now have an exponential equation, we'll write this as a log equation to solve for x. And if you need the review, here are some notes below in red on how to convert an exponential equation to a log equation. The main thing is we want to identify the base, the exponent, and the number. We know we'll have a log in our log equation. The base is e, so we'll have log base e, which we'll write as natural log in just a moment. A logarithm is an exponent. Here our exponent is natural log 2. And this is equal to x, so the number part of the log is x. So again, log base e of x is the same as natural log x. So we have natural log x equals natural log 2. So these two logs are equal to each other, and their bases are the same. Therefore, the number part of the logs must be the same, so x equals 2. So if x equals 2, then this expression is equal to 2 as well. Let's take a look at another example. Here we have 10 raised to the power of common log 3. So we'll set this equal to x and write it as a log equation. So we know we'll have a log. It's going to be log base 10. A log is an exponent. Our exponent is common log 3. It's equal to x, so the number part is x. Again, on the right side, log 3 would be log base 10 of 3. So again, these are equal to each other. Therefore, x must equal 3, which means our original expression simplifies to 3. So let's look at one more example, and then we'll come back and state the shortcut. We have 5 raised to the power of log base 5 of 7. So we'll set this equal to x and write a log equation. Our log will have base 5. A log is an exponent, so the exponent is log base 5 of 7. And this is equal to x, so the number part of the log is x. Therefore, x is equal to 7. Notice in each of these three cases, these expressions simplify to just the number part of the log in the exponent. 5 raised to the power of log base 5 of 7 simplified to 7. 10 raised to the power of common log 3 simplified to 3. And e natural log 2 simplified to 2. So in general, if we have base b raised to the power of log base b of x, this will always simplify to the number part of the log, or in this case, just x. I hope these examples help explain why this property is true, and once we understand it, we can take advantage of it to simplify expressions like this.